week in and week out, prophesy the downfall of this kingdom, America, also the bash, the philosophies of the so-called white men. We're out here to wake up the people of Israel, the Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, and also, you know, to edify the people if they have any questions.
Right.
Yeah, yo, double honors to the elders, a great millstone. Yeah, the apostles, and shalom to the brothers that do the work out there in Caesarea. We're going to start off with basically how Esau pushes to turn things upside down as far as like everything's okay with homosexuality, you know, being wicked, sin like folly and great dignity and things like that. Basically, you know, the brothers going to be getting against
it. You want
Isaiah
29?
Yeah, Isaiah 29.
Okay. This is the book of Isaiah chapter 29, verse 16. Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay.
Yeah, he's turning everything upside down as far as like you're not supposed to build higher than three stories. Everything, well, there's a lot of things here higher than three stories. And that homosexual thing, and then he's pushing that so hard. Like people will say, like you talk about that a lot. It's like because they're pushing it so hard that it's even messing with the kids' minds. So brothers don't even want their kids watching certain things because it's gonna put spirits on them. So it's like, yeah, that's why I said it's a sneak. We're gonna break in pieces basically this kingdom and everything that the white man pushes.
That's right.
We out here battling demons.
That's right. That's why I got to this, man. Esau, he turned everything contrary to what his natural state is supposed to be on the planet Earth, man.
Right.
The Earth is basically out of course because of the rule of this devil, man. He's the reason why when you run water, you know what I'm saying, it's fluoridated, and then a lot of you jakes that live in the ghetto that drink tap water from your faucet, you don't even know that there's chemicals in that water that makes you docile, that can cause certain mental illnesses and stuff like that, man.
Well, it's calcifying your pineal gland.
Exactly, man. And that's just something simple like that, man. You're polluting the air that you breathe, the water that you drink, all right? The food that you eat is not real food, right? Monsanto is taking over everything, man. Everything that you eat in your markets is pretty much genetically modified. It was created in the lab by these devils, man. These same devils that's creating diseases in the CDC. The Center for Disease Control, you know? That's these devils turning this world upside down, man. Nothing's natural anymore.
Go ahead, bro. Yeah, because the brother's even saying, all that stuff that he's doing to pollute your body is to control people more. Like
right.
I was like, I'm from DC, I came out here to work, but I'm eating the food out here, I'm realizing I'm taking I'm sitting on the toilet every day and it's not solid. You know, for the most part, I'm not eating like less than less. You know, when I'm eating, it's going right through me and it's mush. It's not even feel like when I'm sitting on the toilet, it don't even look like real food. So it's like, that's how you know, like, this is not the place, we're not supposed to be here, man. We want to so we can set things in order. And for us to rule, this man gotta go down.
That's right. Right.
That's why your steam shall be a part of this clay, because we're going to break that in pieces. And when you break something in pieces, it's not lightly broken.
That's
you
right.
Break something in pieces, it's like, that shit is shattered.
That's right. That's right.
This shattering is going to be, it's going to be nuclear fire to shatter this thing. In all reality, that scripture is talking about turning things upside down as far as Yahweh Shai. And then they put in the Cheshire Rainbow Shia as Yahweh Shai. People, they call it, people call Jesus Christ.
That's right. That's right.
And for the most part, who you eat, people ignorantly call Jesus Christ is a so-called black man.
Right.
He derives from the tribe of Judah, which is the Negroes.
That's right.
This is Job chapter 9, verse 24. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked.
And who's the wicked? The wicked is the so-called white man. Yeah, he pushes these wicked-ass philosophies as far as just that will. Whatever happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. Man, fuck that shit. Whatever happens in Vegas, most high sees.
That's right. That's right.
It says, he covered the faces of the judges thereof. The main judge covered. created his own image, after the Lord's image of the so-called black man to the image of a so-called white man.
That's right.
You know, that's the main judge, but all the judges, all the apostles, that's what he does. He always calls everybody himself.
That's right.
You know?
That's right.
He read on and says, if not, where, then who is he? And who else is doing that on the earth? Who else is covering all the faces and making it their own, going to other countries and calling that land their own, when they don't belong? And who's trying to spread democracy all over the earth? And they're calling it in the name of justice or in the name of democracy. Really what he's doing over here is robbing the land for all the resources he can get. And then he'll get it so he can bring it on to himself and be more of a power. And when they don't directly just hand over, what does he do? He goes over there with his military and start pounding you up. But the other nations get tired of that.
Sorry.
But if it's not him, then who's doing it? Name another race of people that's doing the wickedness that man is doing, that controls the earth.
That's right. This is the book of Psalms, chapter 82, verse 5. It says, they know not, neither will they understand. They walk on in darkness. All the foundations of the earth are out of course. And pretty much what that means is this earth, the foundations of the world is basically moved out of its place, out of its natural place, man. That's why, like as far as our health is concerned, you got children that are growing into puberty too damn early, man. Girls getting their period around nine years old, you know, growth, because why? Because our children are receiving growth hormones from all the food that they eat, man. And who's in control of the food and the resources?
Right.
Esau.
Right.
You know, that's not natural. The earth is out of course, meaning the different weather patterns, man. You know, you got Esau with his wicked left-hand technology. He used the heart program, which he can cause earthquakes. He can control the seasons, you know.
Make it snow in Georgia.
He can make it snow. He can make it snow in Georgia. He can make an earthquake in Washington, D.C.
He can make it snow in Las Vegas 2 weeks after it's been over 80 degrees.
Exactly, man.
That just happened here a couple, like 2 weeks ago.
Yep.
It was like every day was over 70 degrees, and then overnight it was snowing here in Las Vegas.
That's hey man. That's out of course, man.
Listen.
But that goes back to the first scripture.
Yep.
Surely have you turned the things upside down, man?
Yep.
You know.
With the natural course, of the earth isn't on that no more. He's changed it so much and turned it so much upside down to where. It can do whatever he wants it to do, pretty much.
Like in Daniel, where it says he sought to change the times, seasons, and days. You know what I'm saying? Right now, we coming into the Passover. That's the real beginning of the new year, man. Not no damn the winter solstice celebrating the new year with Janus, the god. The god of two faces, man. You know, looking forward and looking back. But this devil, he done changed everything. You know, the men of the Lord, you know, what we was given in the scriptures, we're supposed to keep the Passover, man, the first high holy day of the year. What do y'all do under the rule of this devil? Y'all gonna keep Easter, which goes back to Ishtar, which goes back to idolatry. I know a lot of you Hispanics, you so-called Mexicans, Puerto Ricans, that's what you finna get into, you know? That's why this white man gotta go, man. This devil gotta go. And then 2/3 of our people that's not hearkening unto this truth, you gotta go right along with it, man. You gotta go too. And the Lord is going to establish righteousness on the planet Earth again. It's going to be brought right side up, not upside down. Thus saith the Lord.
this kingdom's gonna be brought to naught.
Right.
Everything that's held up high in the society is coming down.
That's right.
All you crackers is going to slavery, you're gonna die by nuclear destruction.
That's right.
And if you're not with it and you're not on this side, you're gonna die too.
That's
all
right.
All you Latin, Native Americans and Negroes are gonna die in the society if you don't get with the most, if you don't get right with the most high.
That's right.
Shall speak great words against the Most High.
Yeah, he be speaking great words about against the Most High. They call himself God, you know, like push it. And then if you call himself God, he's trying to be like the Most High. How disrespectful is it that this brother's doing great things in our time? Like, yo, I'm taking the credit for him.
Right.
It's things that he did, though. Instead of like, yeah, that's wicked as hell.
Shall wear out the sense of the Most High.
Yeah, he's wearing us out by making
war with us, man.
Because
what it means to wear out the sense, it means to fight. You know, it means to fight. And we've been fighting with this devil pretty much since the womb, man. We've been fighting with this devil for a long time. And to this very day, man, we still fighting with him. You know, and he pretty much prevailed because the Lord had it, that he appointed that way. But at the end, it's gonna reverse. You know, remember, Jacob took on the hill of Esau, man.
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, at the end of this fight, we gonna get the victory, man.
And once we got the blessing from him, that's when he was like, after mourning my father, I'm gonna begin to slay my brother. And he's still trying to slay us to this day. And
that's
he's been slaughtering and wearing us out. Since he ran into us,
where you was reading that in the book of Daniel, you know what I'm saying? It speaks about the beast that Esau basically controlled, man. The last beast, the fourth beast. That's talking about the Roman Empire, man. And during the ancient Rome, they slaughtered us, man. And they besieged our land. They burned our temples down. You know, they anybody among us that was trying to keep the law, statute, commandments got put to death. You know, matter of fact, even going before them during the time of the Greeks, that's when they came in and they tried to impose our people to come into their philosophy, into their rule. And if you didn't get down with them, you got put to death. Antiochus Epiphanes, that devil, man, he would kill our women if he caught them circumcising their sons. And that's a commandment of the Heavenly Father.
Yep.
So this man, if you trying to keep the laws of the Most High, this man commanded you to get put to death. And that's the reason why our people became Gentiles, because they were forced violently to become heathens, man.
Just like, which he redid again in the years of slavery that we went through.
He did that in the Roman Empire, and then he did that
with this.
And the slavery that took place here in Babylon, man.
We all seen roots.
Exactly.
We all seen the roots.
Yep.
You know, your name is Toby, boy.
Yep.
My name's Kunta Kinte. No, it's Toby.
That's right.
You know? Made us like that by force.
Yeah, he sought to change times, names,
right,
everything, man.